One of the most frequently asked questions we get at Visalus is about what sweeteners we use in our products. A lot of companies will use sugar. I'm just going to show you. This is the amount of sugar that is typically found in most sodas. If you read the ingredients on the back, you'll see that sodas can have up to 39 grams of sugar. That is the equivalent of about 10 to 12 teaspoons of sugar. So we know that Americans consume a lot of sugar today. The average American consumes a whole cup of sugar a day. That is a lot of sugar. And sugar can spike your blood sugar levels and leave you hungry and are not necessarily diabetic friendly. So we have chosen at Visalus to use an artificial sweetener. And we know that that is not something that a lot of people like to hear about. Well, it's the bane of our existence because there is no perfect sweetener at all on the market. You name it, there's something good, there's something not so good about every sweetener on the market. So let's talk about that, right? We know that a lot of people would like us to use stevia. Stevia has only recently been approved in the United States and is derived from a plant. Now, stevia has a bit of a bitter licorice aftertaste that not a lot of people find very appealing. We've been trying to make stevia work in a couple of our new formulas, and we've been trying for about 9 months because it does leave that bitter aftertaste. We know taste is very important to our consumers, so we're not using stevia. Now, some people would like us to use xylitol. Xylitol is a natural sugar alcohol. It's not bad for diabetics. The challenge is it causes diarrhea in about 22% of the population. So one out of every five people watching this video would not have a pleasant experience. The other challenge with xylitol or any of the sugar alcohols is toxicity levels. To use the same amount of xylitol as we currently would need to make Neuro taste as good, that amount of xylitol can be toxic or fatal to a 40-pound dog. So the Scientific Advisory Board does not feel comfortable using the sugar alcohol xylitol. We use something that many people know called sucralose. You often find it in these little packets. Now, the amount of sucralose we use is very small, and the reasons we use it are to keep our products diabetic friendly, to help make our product taste good, but more importantly, it's one of the safest, if not the safest sweetener that we have found on the market today. Sucralose has been approved in over 60 countries worldwide. I like to point that out because if you feel that the FDA maybe doesn't take enough time to approve products before they come to market, then we want to look to the rest of the world where maybe they're a little more conservative. Sucralose is the only sweetener approved in all of those countries. Even stevia has not been approved in as many countries as sucralose. Sucralose has over 110 peer-reviewed articles on safety. Now, a lot of sweeteners have been given a bad name because of aspartame. Aspartame, when it's heated, can degrade and become not quite healthy for you. Sucralose is fine both hot and cold. Now, a common packet of sucralose is about this much product. So you can see it's about a 3/4 to a teaspoon of product. The amount that we use in our product is about the 1/3 to a 1/4 of the amount you would find in a diet soda. So the amount we use is 0.003 milligrams, which I don't know if you can see that from where you're sitting, but it's a very minor amount of sweetener. And it is in there to help keep our shake tasting as great as it does, helps it keep it diabetic friendly, and more importantly, doesn't spike hunger. A lot of sweeteners can spike hunger, which is where I come to agave. Again, good news, bad news, right? Agave is a nectar. Agave often is found in tequila. Agave may be better for tequila than it is for weight loss because agave is about 90% fructose and fructose spikes hunger. So in a weight management program, we don't want to spike the hunger and we want something that's diabetic friendly. So we've scoured the world. We continue to scour the world to see if we can find a safer, better tasting sweetener that doesn't add a lot of calories, doesn't harm you, and doesn't take up a lot of space in your product. So I hope that's a little education on why we use sucralose and why there really isn't a perfect sweetener anywhere on the market.